Installing a new ArcOS firmware on your R36S console right after purchase is a very important process that many people avoid, and later they leave comments saying their console runs slowly, doesn't save games, or has completely stopped turning on. I always recommended replacing the default SD cards with branded ones as soon as you buy a console, because default SD cards are low quality and can fail at any moment. Personally, I prefer using two SD cards, one for the firmware and another for storing and running my game collection. But choosing the right SD card is also tricky, because the console does not work with all SD cards. I talked about this in more detail in this video, where I answered the most common questions about the R36S. Be sure to check it out via the link in the description box. Also, my channel already has two videos on how to install the ArcOS firmware for the R36S console if you're a Mac user or if you don't have a computer but do have an Android phone or tablet. In this video, I'll show you how to install ArcOS firmware on the R36S console if you're a Windows user. But first, you need to choose an SD card for the firmware. I've tried different options and can confidently recommend a 64GB Kodak SD card. It has proven to work well with the R36S console as a storage medium for the firmware. I bought this SD card and my R36S console on AliExpress. To make the purchase even more beneficial, I recommend using promo codes. You can find all the details and product links in the description box. You can also use a smaller SD card. 16GB is enough. And this guide is also suitable for R36H owners, because essentially these are the same consoles, just in different form factors. To begin, I recommend downloading 7-zip to extract archives if you don't already have it installed on your computer. The first step in installing the ArcOS firmware is determining the screen version on your R36S console. To do this, I remove the default SD card from the first slot and insert it into a card reader or directly into the computer if it has an SD card slot. Then I go to the firmware website and follow the link to check the screen version. All the links used in this video, along with a text-based guide, can be found in this post on my Telegram channel via the link in the description box. To check the screen, I need to upload this file from the boot section of the SD card. I click Choose File, navigate to the boot section on the SD card, and select the necessary file. Then I click Identify my screen. At the bottom of the page, I see a message saying I have the original screen, but in your case, it might be a different screen, panel 3 or panel 4. Remember your screen version. Now I can remove this SD card from the computer and set it aside. I won't need it anymore. The next step is downloading the ArcOS operating system archive for the R36S console. The link to the GitHub page with the latest ArcOS firmware version is also available in my Telegram channel. Here we see several firmware versions, one for the console with the original screen, one for the console with a panel 3 screen, and one for the console with a panel 4 screen. You need to download the firmware that matches your screen and your console. In my case, it's the firmware for the console with the original screen. Once you've downloaded the firmware archive, extract it. Right-click on the file and select Extract All. As you can see, I now have a folder containing the extracted firmware file in IMG format. Now we need to write this firmware file to a new SD card. In my case, this is a Kodak SD card. The most commonly used programs for this are Rufus and Etcher. These programs are completely free, and you can find links to them in my Telegram channel. For some reason, Etcher is not recommended, but personally I haven't noticed any issues after using it. And before we continue, please like and subscribe to the channel and leave a comment. This helps me promote the channel. Also, you can click the bell icon so you don't miss any new videos. Thank you for your attention. Let's continue. So, I'll show you two ways to flash the firmware onto the SD card. The first method is using Etcher. I insert the new SD card into the computer. In this PC, I right-click on the SD card and select Format. Here, I don't change anything and leave the file system as exFAT. I click Start. In the pop-up window, I select OK. Formatting is complete. I close the formatting window. Now I open Etcher. First, I need to select the firmware file we just extracted. It's in IMG format. Now I choose the SD card where the firmware will be installed. After that, I click the flash button. Now I just wait for the flashing process to finish. Once that's done, remove the SD card and we'll move on to the next step. Now I'll show you how to flash the firmware onto an SD card using Rufus. So you've inserted a new SD card into the computer. You've formatted it as exFAT. Now you're ready to proceed with the firmware installation process. Launch Rufus. In the device field, select your new SD card. Then go to Boot Selection. Here select Disk or ISO image. Next to it, choose the recently extracted firmware file in IMG format. Then I click Start. The firmware writing process begins, and now I just have to wait for it to finish. After that, remove the SD card. Now you know two ways to write the firmware to an SD card. You can choose either method. Next, I insert the SD card into the R36S console. At this point, the second SD card with the game collection is not inserted. Now I turn on the console. The console begins the installation process. It doesn't take long, just a couple of minutes. The device will reboot several times, and then you'll see the ArcOS home screen. Right after that, I go to Options and enter the Device Type section. Here I select my console model, R35S or R36S, and press the A button. Then I press the A button again to confirm. Great, the basic settings have been applied for my device type. Now I insert the second SD card with the game collection. I have separate video on my channel explaining how to transfer your games to a new SD card. Be sure to check it out via the link in the description box, and don't use default SD cards. Once the second card is inserted into the second slot, I go to the Advanced section and scroll to the bottom to select Switch to SD2 for ROMs. I press the A button. During this process, the console will switch to reading games from the second SD card, and as a result, on the main screen, I see the full list of available systems for playing games. Now the console is ready to use, and you can dive into playing your favorite games. By the way, my channel has many other videos on customizing the R36S console and improving performance, for example in PSP games. In the description box, I've left a link to a playlist with all videos related to R36S. I'm sure you'll find a lot of new and useful information. Now you can play your favorite games on a stable ArcOS firmware with a good SD card. Remember that you can buy a Kodak SD card and the R36S console at a great price on AliExpress. And don't forget to use promo codes. Find all the details in the description box. I hope this video was helpful for you. Please like and subscribe to the channel. I wish you pleasant nostalgia and successful completion of your favorite games.